This is it.
I never knew that.
Ah!
This has got to be it. Now, where'd you hide the stash, Leon? Maybe in one of these.
Got it.
I just gotta figure out who I'm gonna give this to.
Boozer! Boozman, are you listening? Oh, you're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper!
Chopper? What are you talking about?
A Nero chopper! It just buzzed right over me and acted like I wasn't even there!
Wait, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I'm gonna chase him down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing!
Be careful. Don't get too close to me.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid. Hold on, they're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
We could be friends now, can't we?
I bring the freaks in.
Shit.
Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. That us?
No, that's O'Brien.
Got it.
Oh, shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
This would be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Did you hear me? Over 400 subjects. And these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage three.
They're sleeping like babies.
No.
And I asked if you were going in. Didn't say I was.
These subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors of the White King Mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like he was peeling a banana. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. Not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was FUBAR from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
I think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
See the caves? Yeah, right, like anyone gives a damn.
Did you see something?
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Deke, hey, I'm here.
Hold on, farewell. The Nero guy, the soldier,
whatever the hell he was,
took Sarah.
What are you?
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
God, O'Brien. You wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Hey, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard...
Okay, well,
I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait, you went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen to me. I heard them over the radio, talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't.
Not, Boozer, I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Deacon out.
Renegade Patrol, goddammit!
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The start of this living hell that is now our life came
hell?
As a surprise
someone's
to
trap.
No one was listening to me or shit went down. Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't come so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know. Because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last weeks before the feds fell. Broadcast from an unmarked van, moving from town to town. In the days before the roads came choked with cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
No, Cope, the cemeteries are filled with freakers, not martyrs. No.
Another mobile medical unit. Oh, gotta find a way inside. See if there's another injector. Here's the generator. feels. Yes. Boozer, no, no, you're gonna get yourself killed. You gotta wait till you're whole, brother. I'm over here anyway, so I'll take care of the mess, okay?
Yeah, okay. Thanks, Deke.
Deke, wait till tonight. If you were freaks inside those nests. Or take my bounce right out to be more than nothing will be as strong. Finish burning out these nests. Sniper on the road. Oh, goddammit. Mean sons of bitches, aren't you?
Black helicopters. You said this spotted in the skies. You might have seen them. Heard them. Thought you were losing your mind. But you're not. They're real. And they're proof that I was right. We thought Nero died out here like the rest of them. Caving under their own stupidity. But no. Like I said,
I gotta cut down on the swarmers out here.
This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Jesus, Cope, they're not trying to reclaim shit! You don't have a damn clue what you're talking about. Well, except, yeah, they will shoot you on sight. Lucky guy.
Trouble, throw your ass out.
Where's Tucker? Alki.
Over at the dig site.
Well, which one, goddammit?
The north one. Back there.
Anybody touches this bike, or anything on it, I break your fingers.
Whatever, man. Jesus.
I keep telling you, everywhere you look, it's all one giant lava field. 25 feet solid rock. It'll take jackhammers to...
I don't need a lecture, goddammit. I get it.
No, you don't. But these people are hungry. Even if they had all their strength. It'll take them months to finish this job with picks and shovels.
I don't give a shit! We're all hungry, Al. But this job's gotta get done, whether it takes all goddamn year. It's not like we got somewhere else to be now, do we?
Wait. Not finished.
We'll make it quick, will ya, Al? I got things to do.
Rippers. This morning, one of my men spotted a large group of them coming over the pass.
And no one stopped them?
How the f... Tucker, you know we're already spread thin.
Are they headed north? Al, are they headed towards us? Yes or no?
I don't know. Maybe he knows.
What the fuck are you up to now, huh? What's this about, huh?
Damn it, Alkai. It's not his job to know. It's your goddamn job to know.
I can't be at two places at one time. You either want me here, running your jig, or you want me out there in the shit, chasing the Rippers.
Go check the store, see how much ammo we got left. I'll tell Wheeler to watch the dig.
What are you looking at?
Oh, I don't know, just waiting for you to smarten the fuck up.
Don't! Did you track down Leon? Good thing someone around here knows how to make things happen. Ride with me. How long's it been since you found someone, brought him in?
The kind of people left out in the shit aren't the kind of people you want me bringing in.
We lost two more to the fever.
Hey,
it's not my problem.
Get your ass back to
you want our food? I'm making it your problem.
I told you, we'll do runs for you, but we're not joining your goddamn camp.
Remind me again, my old woman's memory. Why is that?
Because it's a waste of time, Tuck.
Well, aren't you the optimist? Where's Boozer?
He said he was gonna head over to Copeland's camp, see about trading for some fish.
You're not in bed with Cope now, are you? His camp near yours?
It's not closer or further. Look, I'm not Boozer's old lady. He goes where he wants. Jesus. You keep this shit burning all day and night.
Got a lot of freak corpses piling up out here. With men like you doing your jobs. Damn right we keep it burning.
Try using more gasoline. It burns faster, less fumes.
Like we got so much to spare? When it's all gone, what are you gonna put in that bike of yours? Spit and sweat? Now what the hell is going on here?
The count's off. Storage is missing food and some ammo.
Jesus. Who was on watch last night?
Wheeler.
Tonight, double the watch. This shit's starting to piss me off.
You got it.
Trouble in paradise.
It's like I was saying. Camp's like a prison. Bunch of goddamn lazy liars, thieves, rapists, and murderers. You know why that is?
No idea.
'Cause that's who we are. The freak show. Only folks survived were those mean enough, nasty enough to out-freak the freaks. The rest are here, hoping I feed them, protect them, keep them nice and cozy and warm, so they can sit on their asses and watch the world end. You! Get your ass back to work! Don't make me go get Cyrus! Lazy sons of bitches can screw around all they like on their time. Daytime is my time. Running this camp is no different than running a prison.
I can't remember what you said. You were what? You were a warden or something?
Nothing so high and mighty. I was matron of the women's ward. You look like the sort who might have spent some time in the pen, back in the day. You ever do time?
I had my share of trouble, but I never landed in K-State.
I got a job for you. Larson was on a run yesterday. Passed through Marion Forks, said he saw someone. Young woman looked like. But he only caught a glance. He stopped to look around, but he never found her.
Come on.
Is he sure?
Larson's been doing this long as you. He knows a person from a freak. But you got a knack for this. You head over there and find her before the freaks do.
I'll see what I can do. But look, Tuck, I want the rest of my credits for Leon.
You bring me warm bodies, I'll give you all the credits you can spend. I gotta go find Wheeler. Someone's looking at a night in the shack.
Alkai. What do you want, Drifter? problem?
Hmm?
One of my men escaped to Ripper Camp over by Iron Butte. Got tortured, like they always do. But this time, they kept asking me if you knew about it. Two bikers, two men, asking if you'd ever seen them or heard of them.
A lot of bikes around here. What's it, what's it got to do with me?
The Ripper called them mongrels. How many drifters still flying colors around here? As if that shit matters. If you ask me, you got a price on your head. How's it feel to be on the other side?
Now, why don't you just show me what you got, because I don't have time for your bullshit.
Whatever you say, Deke.
You could use a gun like that. Come by if you still need something.
I just gotta figure out who I'm gonna give this to. We can't head north until I get this bike fixed up. Copeland it is.
Can I help you?
Deke, you got your radio on? I grabbed you a couple of items if you want to swing by.
Oh, those men. Yes, yes. Always need more shit.
Thanks, brother. Deke out.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. This earth is a gift for us all, to use as we see fit, to provide for ourselves and our families. I'm not saying this. It's the Lord that gave us dominion over it. But that wasn't enough for some men. They wanted more. When our fuel got low, they jacked up the prices so they could consolidate power into their own hands. So, we wanted to build dams for electricity. But their precious runs of salmon were more important than heating our homes. We wanted to cut a few trees to build those homes. But the nests of a few spotted owls were more important than the entire timber industry. Now that the feds have gone to ground, let's just say we've eliminated the middleman. No one can stop us from taking what's rightfully ours. This is Mark Corral for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Thing is, Cope, fuel prices have actually come down lately. Way down. Only problem is you gotta find it yourself, and last I checked, there's plenty of assholes out here trying to take what's rightfully ours.
Help me, please!
Shit, someone needs help.
John, you out there? I got a job for you here at the hot springs.
Tucker, okay, I'll head your way. St. John out.
Nah, you gotta leave the bike out here, Deke, or it'll pull all of them down on you.
fire in the hole. How'd you like that?
Huh? Come on, you son of a bitch, come on!
Okay, one nest done. How many more you got?
Oh, shit!
For the camp. I just wanted to say thank you.
Oh, warehouse. Yeah, that looks like the kind of place you want to call home, yeah. God damn it, what you all shit yourself at once? Jesus Christ. Oh, goddamn freaks. What the hell are you doing in here? Huh? This place is a death trap. Oh, Jesus. Okay, gotta be careful.
Thank you.
gonna warn you.
That's all of them in here.
Deacon St. John, this is Tucker. Like I said before, I haven't seen Loser Sweet Face around these last few days. You sure he's all right?
This is Deacon. Boozer's fine. Like I said, he's just been busy.
Doing runs for that son of a bitch, Mark Copeland, no doubt. I get the feeling he doesn't like me much. Boozer, I mean.
Like I said, I ain't his old lady. Deacon out.
Okay. Oh, there's gotta be a nest in this shack. Oh, yeah, a nest. Okay, you boys just keep right on sleeping. Don't pay no attention to me. Come on, boys and girls. Let's do this. Is that the last of them? Finally.
Boozer, it's done. I cleared those nests. Should be less freaks in the mouth.
Hey, Dick. How'd it go? Were there a lot of them?
Nah, it wasn't too bad. That's why I wanted to take them out of the dark out. Some of them were strong as hell. Yeah, Boozer. I need that. Guess I'm shut out, Boozer. Peeking out.
Says you've been helping out around the camp.
Hey, Cope. I think Leon was bringing you this.
Geek. You made a wise choice. Wise choice. You go see Manny. Maybe he can help you with that bike of yours.
How's it going, D? Hey, Manny.
You feeling any better?
Manny, what's going on?
What's up?
What's going on?
Deke, you there?
Boozer, where the hell aren't you in your damn bunk?
I couldn't sleep. Remember what I said back in the tunnel? Don't go up there, Deke. It's making you crazy.
Boozer, I go up there because there's freaks up there. I get them here, I kill them there. Bounties are all the same to me.
Then what are the tulips for, huh? I saw them, Deke. Here on the table. This morning. The same one she had at the wedding. I remember.
I'm mucking up. Listen, Boozer, get some rest. I gotta go. Deacon out.